Hello, my name's Linda and I'm an independent stamping up demonstrator, and this is my blog Stamping by the Beach, and today I'm going to show you a card I've made, and I've been using the Magical Day bundle. And here is the first card I made, and I've just used pink pirouette, and I've cut out my unicorn, coloured it in and put a celebrate on the front. And then I thought I'm going to step it up a bit, so card number one, I hope that's right, it's okay, and then I did it again, but this time I used first the mark ink and I stamped all these little flowers, and I can't remember the top of my head what that stamp set is, but I'll put it on the screen up here somewhere. And I used white embossing powder, and then using Flirty Flamingo ink I sort of went round and round just with one of the little finger dabbers with the ink, just so it made the embossing stand out a bit. And then I made another one again using the same stamp set. This time I used the knight, and exactly the same sort of principle, celebrate at the bottom. And this time I made myself a stencil using the okay, might have been a little bit of a pause there because my son just walked in. So I made a stencil, and I use the Eclectic Layers Finlits, and I use this die here. Just run it through the Big Shot a few times just to make this stencil, and then I just went over it with basic grey. There we go, and then I did the inside as well, a little bit on the corner at the inside. So I'm going to show you another two cards. Next, we're going to be using the mermaid. So, let me show you what I did. Let's bring it all in. So, I've had a piece of A4 cardstock, so A4 long ways this way, and I've cut it at 20 centimetres. So, it's a normal A4 size along the top, 20 centimetres down, and I've done one in Bermuda Bay and one in Smoky Slate, I think that is. And then, I've just gone to 10 centimetres and score. So we're not cutting here, we're scoring. And this is making, I think they're like the DL size card. There we go, don't need that anymore. Put that on the floor. And as I said, I'm going to start with the mermaid first. So just fold this over. And there is our base for our card. And then, let me get some more pieces in. I have a piece of Whisper White cardstock, and I've cut this at 9 centimetres by 20 centimetres, and it's going to fit in here. It doesn't fit, so I've not cut that correctly. Let me just go and cut that. Okay, I hadn't cut it at 9. I had not cut it at 9. I've cut it at 10. So there you go, and that's how it's going to go. And I've made another little stencil, if I can find it. Here it is. And what I've used from the Magical Day set, I've used some of these bubbles and these leaves, I suppose they are, but I'm going to use them as seaweed. And then from the Bubble Over set, I've used some more bubbles that I had. But you could, if you don't have the Bubble Over set, you could just use these all the way along. And I'm going to put the green along the bottom. I'm going to just bring a piece of paper in, just so I don't go all over my desk. And I've used the Lemon Lime Twist, and I've used the re-inkers, but you don't have to use the re-inkers. If you've got the ink, you can just squeeze it into the top of the lid and use it that way. So the trick is, once you decide where you want to put your stencil, lay it down and then don't move it. So you mustn't move the top and you mustn't move the bottom. And because I'm very slapdash lazy, I'm not going to stick it down. I'm just going to go over it with my ink. That's broken a bit there. Okay. It's nice to sort of vary the colour a bit, so sort of a little bit of dabbing, so you get a little bit darker, lighter. Let's have a look and see what it looks like. And there we go. And I'm just going to go all the way along the bottom of my card, doing the same. this stamp set bundle, it retires. So from the 31st of May, you will not be able to purchase this anymore. There we go. And I'm just going to go right along to the other end. So if you would like it, don't leave it. Don't leave it too long to get it, because they might run out and they will not be making any more. So as soon as they run out, that's it. And if you did want to order them, you can go to my blog, Sand by the Beach, and at the top of my blog I have a shop button, so you can click on that. Okay, so there's the bottom, and now I'm going to do the top. And for the top I'm going to use bubbles. Got a bit of shadow there. Let me just turn one of my lights off. And I've got a bit of, I'm just using a bit of it's like a baby sponge that I had left over. Obviously it's fairly old because my children aren't babies anymore. And then I'm going to do the bubbles at the top. So I'm using Bermuda Bay, and I'm also going to use Pool Party. And it's great using the reinkers in a different way. Well, they're not actually, they're quite inexpensive. But even if you don't have the ink pad, you can use the reinkers. Oh, look at that. Brilliant. And then I'm going to do this corner. Okay, so clear the desk. I've finished. I did make a little bit of an error there, and what I did in the end, I used my stencil and just used whatever ink I had left in just to do these sort of background bubbles. I've not tried this, I'm not really sure how it's going to work out. So what I then did was I stamped out my mermaid, and what I usually do when I do that is, and this isn't the mermaid, this is the knight, I stamp it out a few times and then I start colouring it in. So I'll do his face, all of them, then the sword, all of them, etc, etc, and that way it's much quicker to colour them all in, and then I can save them from another card. And let me get my mermaid out. So here's my mermaid all ready. I'm hoping I might be able to stick her over that little error. Okay, and I've cut out using the glimmer paper that comes with this set, and this is the Bermuda Bay. It's lovely, isn't it? And I've used, on the back, I've used the multi-purpose adhesive sheet, so it's completely sticky. And I'm just going to stick that down there, so I'm going to do that now. My fingers have got quite inky. Okay. It just makes it so easy to use these fiddly dies. And I'm going to lay that down. I'm just eyeballing the middle, but you could measure. And you get to move this round a little bit as well when you've got the adhesive sheet on the back. And just push it down, and that's where I want it to go. And I have my little mermaid, and I've already put some dimensionals and some mini dimensionals on the back of her, just so she pops up a little bit. There we go, and I'm going to pop that up so it just covers up that. What error? Error's disappeared. And I've also, while I was stamping, I stamped the little teeny tiny seahorse that goes with the same set, and I was going to pop that somewhere just with a little dab of glue. If I can find my glue, just for a little bit more. I think I'm going to put it in there. It's bobbing around with his mermaid. Okay, and then we're going to bring in our base, and we're going to pop that on. So even though all of these cards started from the same very simple idea, they're all turning out quite different. Okay, that's straight. So paranoid about putting my head in the picture. There we go. And then inside, I've just cut another piece of whisper white, exactly the same size. That was 9 by 20. Hopefully, I've cut it the right size. And I've already put some little bubbles on, and I'm just going to stick that on the inside. And you could stamp another sentiment on there if you wanted to. I'm going to leave mine blank on this occasion. And then when I come to use the card, I can either stamp something in, because as it says celebrate, that could be celebrating anything, couldn't it? Doesn't just have to be a birthday, could be anything. So there we go. And so now I'm just going to do another one. And using the I can't remember what it's called, what is it called? Smoky Slate. Again, just fold that in half, and this one's even quicker. So I'm using the DSP that comes with the bundle, like you can buy with the bundle, and I'm going to put this on the front here. And this makes this one super quick. And it's got really cute clouds on the back, which would look really good with your unicorn. That's all the DSP's double-sided. And on this occasion, I have stamped out the wizard. Let's just pop him out for you. And I have already coloured him in. So he's going to go in the middle there. And I've already cut out my celebrate. And this time, I'm using the silver foil. Actually, I think I'm going to really like this one. This one's really quick and easy to make as well. Again, dimensionals are already on him, just to save a little bit of time. And I used the stamping blends to colour these in. And I'm going to pop him in the middle, hopefully. And to finish that off, I have also some of these left over, and what are these called? The clear faceted gems. And I'm going to use one of these big ones, and that's going to be, whoa, that's on the floor. Let's get another one, and I'm going to put that in his hand. And it looks like he's holding a nice ball of magic. And then again on the inside, I've already cut my piece of whisper wire, and I've stamped a few stars around the edge there that come with that magical day stamp set. A little bit of glue, and then put that in. There we go. Now let's just bring them all in. There's the two made today. Not sure about that one. Perhaps I should have practiced it first. But I do like all the others. The unicorn, the one that I originally made with no decoration at all, and the celebrate. Let's actually get them in shot, Linda, that helps. And there we go. I really hope you enjoyed my tutorial, and please give me a thumbs up. Thank you very much. Bye.